It was the dawn of the third age of mankind.
So this video is to give you a sensibility of how we're going to be using GitHub as programmers. So you've already created your GitHub account, so you go over there and log in. You log in with GitHub. If you want, you can set up a cool profile picture, because a lot of students put their GitHub repository on the top of their resume if you're going for the IT job, and it looks kind of impressive if it shows the employer you're into doing a bunch of IT stuff. So here I'm going to make, here's what you're going to do. So sorry, I forget, Harleen, I think, and everybody follow along, or you can watch this video later. Let's all work together and make a GitHub repository for this course. Because then later on, whatever you need to send me, if I ask you to send me your work or something, then you will, you'll have your repository set up and ready to go. You can also follow me on GitHub. See, I have a bunch of students following me. So then whenever I contribute something, then, and I've achieved being an Arctic Code Vault contributor. I don't know what that means, but it sounds pretty impressive. So if you follow me, then you'll get notified every time I do some updates or something. So step one is I'll go here, and I'll say make a new repository. A repository is a file system up on the GitHub server where you can store your code. And you could make it private, right? So if it's a company and they say, well, you know, this is our product code. We don't want our competitors to go in there and steal our intellectual capital or something. But just leave it public for now. That's good. And repository name, call it whatever you like. I'm going to call it Intro to Java Programming Course. You can call it, I don't know, just whatever. Call it whatever you like. And, now I'm going to say create repository, and now I can start putting files there, right? So I will actually put some of the files you guys were asking about, like a few people were asking, and I know instructors who do this, they use GitHub to keep track of all of their stuff because it versions it by date and stuff. Well, we got another 15 minutes. I think we're okay here. So I'm going to say choose your files, so I can drop them here. So I'm going to actually put right here some of the files you guys were asking about. Like some people wanted my notebook and my workbook from last week, so I'll put them up in GitHub. And some of the other good ones you should have are... Now the textbook is too big, like... GitHub does not really deal well with very large files, so I'm not going to put the textbook there. That's in your Google Classroom. But here are some good files I think you should study, because I can tell some of you guys are pretty interested into this. I got some very good advanced questions. I was chatting with some students during the break, so you guys should jump into there and get that. And what else is there? Those are probably the main things for right now. Well, there is the activity zip files. I guess I could put that there for you as well. And I'm going to be adding in our code. So this little starter code we made today, I'm going to put it here as well. But Harleen, pay attention. So you want to know how to work with GitHub. So now I've put some stuff. So now I have to say commit changes. So I click on commit changes. And you can put comments as well. We'll get to that another day. We don't need that right now. So we'll just say commit changes. And you now have a repository. Oh, I have a nice video and I have a PowerPoint as well. Since you guys are asking, I'm going to get you this stuff. So let me give you I'm just going to take a couple of seconds to get you some of my stuff I've developed for other classes. So where's Google Classroom? So go to Google Classroom. And now we'll make a new entry here and we'll say GitHub for programmers, because GitHub can be used by other people, right? System administrators, database administrators. They put their SQL code there and stuff. We're going to be using it as we would normally use it in a programming IT development environment. So GitHub for programmers. And I've got some video actually on my, on my YouTube channel, The Prof. You guys can follow me on YouTube as well, because I have a bunch of stuff from all of my other courses there too. So let's go to YouTube, The Prof. The Prof. Where's The Prof? Where's The Prof? Oh, I'm here's The Prof now. So go to your videos. And let's find GitHub. I've got a bunch of them here. All right, so that's, I guess, getting started. So I'll get you that one. Probably a good one as well. I'm going to create a GitHub invitation. All right. And I've got some good PowerPoints on it as well I'm going to share with you. Oh, actually, that's my video. So where did my... Hang on just a sec. I'm just going to turn off screen sharing and look at my Dropbox because I've got a really good PowerPoint on it. Oh, please share your screen. Sorry. Yeah, now the part of the screen that you missed was not very important. It was just me uploading stuff. So yeah, I did turn it off before, but you didn't really miss anything because it was just me finding files and uploading them. So sorry that you didn't see that, but it was not any instructional stuff. It was just to show you that all the things you need are here. And one other thing is my PowerPoint on GitHub. GitHub PPTX. Somebody was asking me before the break about how to use GitHub. I'll talk about that another day. But one thing I love about GitHub is I have all my stuff there and it's easy to search for it. So I know I have a PowerPoint on GitHub, so I can say GitHub. And I can even specify the file type, and then it goes through all my stuff and finds it. So, well, I don't know. I'll find it later and put it up there. Oh, I don't know where my GitHub PowerPoint is. Now, I'm running a Camtasia video of this, so the stuff that I was doing when the screen sharing was turned off, you can, I mean, if you really need to see it, you can watch that Camtasia video as well. Using GitHub. Well, anyway, that's not a PowerPoint. So now let's make sure, let's do this one step at a time. So you guys who want to study more on GitHub, there's some good stuff there you can go and get. And now let's finish this up because we're getting near the end of our class. So here is some stuff I did with my program during the break. So first of all, I'm going to take this and make it into a GitHub repository. So I'll copy it. And if you want to grab this code and play with it, I'm going to send you the link. Or you can just follow me on GitHub so you'll always get updated. So I'll say add file. And I could upload an existing file. I could do that. Or usually I just use create file because it's a little bit faster. So I'll say create file. And my network's a little... Shoot, what's wrong with my network? Sometimes I'm worried my meeting is going to die because... No, my meeting is still here. Why am I having trouble with the network? Because I couldn't get to Amazon either. That's bizarre. Oh, shoot, I lost this whole meeting. Jesus. Right. Yeah, for some reason my network died, but I'm back now, so hopefully everybody can still hear me. We're into the last couple of minutes of class. I'm just going to share my screen again. And what I was saying here is you go into GitHub and so now I want to make a file for my code. So I'll paste it in there with Control V. And I'll give it a name. I'll call it Game Code Starter. One.java. And then I'll say commit. That's something in GitHub, right? Watch my video. I talk about that. It works with the commit cycle. And now you can always jump in there and get my code. And I'll give you guys this link. So this is going to be... I'll make this to be our main repository throughout our class. So every week we'll update stuff there. So you can get the... I have to leave in a couple of minutes. Well, another 8 minutes. I have to go and launch my other class in a minute. But now, guys, I teach this same class again from 11 till 2. If you want, you're welcome to. You don't have to. Your class is over. But if you're desiring to see these things more, to see it a second time or something... You're welcome to stay. I'm going to keep the same link. I'm just going to share it out to my other class. So here we're going to go chat, and we're going to call this the course GitHub repo. And follow me. Why not? Because then you can always get updated when I kick stuff up there. And I'm also going to put it in your PowerPoint. And now I'm just going to spend a couple of minutes finishing up our little program here so we can get some closure on that. So let's go back to Sublime. And now you see what I've done here is I declared a variable, and that's something we did last week as well. But what about args? Well, args is an array. We're not going to have time this week to talk about arrays. We'll start on it next week. But I'm getting the... thing which somebody types in at the command line, and I'm dumping it out. So I'm saying string name equals the args array, the zeroth position, and then I'm saying let's play a game, and I'm addressing them by name. So let's go and run that and see how that program runs. So here we'll say Java, and then peanut is the program, and I'm passing in some parameter, and that parameter is being caught as a command line argument. And I'm going a bit fast. If you don't understand what I'm saying, we'll start again next week. But that's saying that whoever runs this program, if they give some command line argument, we're going to capture it. So here we're going to say Joe, and the program is echoing back, and it's saying Joe. It's just echoing back out the name. Now, I made some changes. I don't think I recompiled them because it's not saying let's play a game. So let's say I saved it, and I'll compile it again. So I'll say javac compile, and I got some error here, so I have to fix this next week. Well, anyway, we'll get to that later. Printlin is not applicable. Oh, I see. Yeah, so because I could get around that, but we have to introduce formatters next week, which is a bit more complicated. But if I say plus, I think that'll work. I have one more minute before I have to bail out and start my next class. So let's say save. And let's compile again. Oh, I have a comment coming in. Well, we are. Jace Meat, we are going to write code for a game. And this code we're writing is the starter point of our game. The way it's going to work is when you run the program, it asks the user for their name, and then it says, let's play a game, and then it says, guess a number, and then the program randomly generates a number, and if the user's number is the same as what the game guessed, user wins or else user loses. So that's going to be our game, and it's going to just build it up. But today, because last week I got a number of feedback from students saying they were worried they wouldn't do well in the course because they didn't understand what I was saying. So I just slowed it down a pile, but we'll get to there. Don't worry, we'll be okay. And I also have, if you go to my professor YouTube channel, I actually have a series on Java where I talk about how to do this game anyway, but we'll get to it next week. But let me quickly finish this up here. So I'm going to say save, and I'm going to say compile. Oh yeah, so now it should work. So I fixed the problem. Now it's compiling. Now let's run it. And now it's saying, let's play a game, Joe. So now we're getting set up because now we have to see how to randomly generate a number. And then we have to ask Joe to provide a number and we have to see if his answer agreed with ours or not. But next week, we're going to pick it up right here. So I'm going to now go and invite my next class. And you guys can stay if you like because I have a professional subscription to Zoom. I can have 500 attendees in a meeting. If you want to see more of this, it's up to you, or I'll kick out the recording later. Anyway, I got to go, guys. Go bye, go and have a nice weekend, or hang around and stay, either way, but I need to invite my new people in. So I'm going to do that now, and I'll be with you guys again next week. And you can watch this recording that I just made as well.